chance to meet a girl named Jasmine, things are going your way. It's a cause to celebrate. I've got to borrow my mom's car for the first time. It was a 1992 Dodge Colt, and it was teal. It was the least tough car and the least tough color imaginable, and I was very concerned about being tough. I was even skinnier and more awkward than I am now, and it was 35 below zero. It was January in Winnipeg. We're going to meet at the cheap seats on Pembina Highway, and you can get a ticket to see Miss Doubtfire for $2.50. I got there an hour and a half early. She was going to be the girl in the purple hat. And I waited for her. She walked through the door, and I just melted. This must be what love is. This naive version of love, but it was the only time I'd ever tasted that. It was like all cylinders were firing perfectly. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know how to impress her, so I did what my dad does when he gets in trouble. He just starts spending cash. So I go to the counter, and I order the ocean of Coca-Cola, and I order the mountain of popcorn, and be sure that I'm a cosmopolitan man, you know, that I'm not some inbred from St. Norbert. I get this gigantic box of Junior Mint chocolate. I figure, you know, there's no way she's going to resist any of my charms when she realizes how refined my palate is. That's like the holy trinity of treats, you know. You got that salty popcorn and that Coke, the bite of the Coca-Cola and that cool mint finish. I couldn't imagine she could resist me. So we got into the theater and we sat down in those theater seats. They felt 2 miles wide, you know. And so I got all the way over to her side of the seat, because maybe then our arms might graze, you know. If our arms grazed, then maybe something else might graze. And now the cylinders were firing a little bit too hot. Now, I don't know if it's the same in Saskatchewan, but you don't really care what's on the screen. You're going to the movie so you can warm up. They just pump those theaters full of heat in the wintertime, and you can wear a t-shirt in there and kind of get to thaw out a bit. You know? But I was nervous, and so I was doing more than thawing. I was perspiring. You know? And about halfway to Miss Doubtfire, I had to do what's clinically called a typical male pant adjustment maneuver. You may have seen it, you may have never heard the title, but if you see a guy kind of get up from his chair and kind of go like this, he's trying to settle everything back down. So in the process of this typical male pant adjustment maneuver, I realized that there was a very strange substance on my inner thigh. And then it dawned on me that I had spilt that entire box of Junior Mints on the seat. And that I'd been sitting on them for the first half of the movie. So I run to the bathroom, I take off my beautiful pleated khaki pants, and I lift them up to the fluorescent lights of that cheap seat theater bathroom. I begin scraping that chocolate mint goo with my nails. It's a huge mistake, because the foreign substance began to look a lot less like a foreign substance and a lot more like a local substance. And if you could explain to your date why you've been gone 20 minutes upon returning with a brown stain on your trousers, you're probably better at love than me. So I got back into the theater, and all of a sudden those seats, they felt tiny. And I just tried to crawl all the way to the other side. I just waited for those lights to come up. And as soon as they came up and the credits rolled, all I could think to do was stand up and tie my big down parka up around my waist. The international sign for I shit my pants. I wandered out to the Winnipeg winter night in a t-shirt. Arms turning blue, offer Jasmine a ride home in my beautiful teal. Of course she said no. I think back to that night and I think, I don't know if I'd ever be writing songs if I didn't taste defeat like that. I'll take you to my little town of Inglis, New Year's Eve in a social. And maybe I was falling in love for the first time, truly, you know. And maybe I was dancing just a little too earnestly to Kim Mitchell. This one's called Patient Man.